This is for the consolidation worksheet for 23rd January, question 4. We are looking at the topic of sequences and series, so just to recall, recap that down. This is for sequences and series, and it's 23rd Jan, right, 2017. Alright, using the result summation R square equals to 106 n plus 1 to n plus 1, we want to show that the summation of R plus 1, 3R minus 2, plus 3 power 1 minus 2R, equals to the following term. Okay, so what we need to do, using the understanding that we have, we try to solve for our summation. Okay, so let's look at number one. Let's just quickly look at how this summation looks like. Okay, so we have R plus 1, 3R minus 2, plus 3 to the power of 1 minus 2R. Okay, very quickly, we look at this. One thing we do is, if you observe this, right, there's nothing much you can do. Easiest way is really just to expand it, right? So expand, and you can see that generally your terms will look much simpler. Okay, this is 3r square plus r minus 2 plus 3. Okay, r equals to 1. Maybe I just got the it's just a summation of n r equals to 1, 3, 1 minus 2r. Okay. And from here, right, from here, given that you know that summation is distributive, we can also quickly distribute the terms out, write it out in the sum of the individual terms, right? And then you can see that, oh, now it really looks like something that's manageable because it looks familiar. And this is given in your question. Okay, this is from your own understanding. And over here, this is just a summing, a summation of a constant for n times, right? How about this? Alright, so this actually, right, if it looks very scary, you just think about it, this is the same as n, r equals to 1, 3 to the power of 1, multiplied by 3 to the power of negative 2r. Okay, so it still looks very scary, so how about we take the 3 out, you know that r equals to 1, 3 negative 2r. Alright, so if it's still very uncomfortable, what you can do is you can try writing out maybe the first 3 terms of this summation. Okay, I don't recognize anything right now. So you see, the first 3 terms, you have 3, negative 2, 3, negative 4, 3, negative 6, right? So you just have 3, negative 6. What does it look like? Okay, if you are observant enough, you can see that now it looks like there's a general pattern, right? Where your first term is probably, you can see it's like 1 over 3 square, okay? Your common ratio is also 1 over 3 square. Okay, it looks like a GP, am I right? Okay, so if you have guessed that this one is a GP, yes, you are right. So summing this, right, is just like summing a GP. And we can also rewrite this in a better way. Let's just write it maybe, let's write it maybe 1 over 3, this is the same as 3, and r equals to 1. 1 over 3 to the power of 2r, right? Right, okay, so 3 to the power, I can also write it this way. We can write it as r equals to 1, 1 over 9 to the power of r. But either way, no matter how you express, you will still be able to get the answer. So here, right, 1 over 9 to the power of r, you can also say that this is a 3 summation r equals to 1, 1 over 9 to the power of r. And this is a summing of this, because it's actually you are just nothing but summing a GP. Okay? So that's explaining the third portion. So very quickly, let me rewrite everything neatly. Okay, so we just get summation r equals to 1. What we have just now, 3 r square plus the summation of r minus n r equals to 1, summation of 2 plus 3, what we have explained just now, this is 1 over 9 to the power of r. Okay, we recall that this is a GP where your first term is 1 over 9, your common ratio is actually also 1 over 9, right? And from here, okay, we're just going to use the summation of a GP. The sum of a GP, if you still don't know, please go and revise 1 minus r to the power of n, 1 minus r. So very quickly, we have 3, this is the 3, summation 1 over 9a, 1 minus r to the power of n over 1 minus r. Okay, this is for the third term. Second term, what does this give us? You are summing the constant 2 for how many times? Okay, n 1 to n. Okay, you should by now, you should know you should have n. You have n terms. So this is just 2 times n. Okay, next one, what do we have? It's just summing r. Very quickly, you write out your formula. This is just n plus 1 over 2. Okay, you should remember this easily. Don't know something is wrong. Okay, this one, what is this? This is just 3. And using the question, right, they tell you this 1 over 6, n plus 1, 2n plus 1. Okay, with that, you have your answers just appearing in front of you. Simplifying all of them, okay, so this will give us half n. Okay, simplifying inside, you have 2n squared plus 3n plus 1. Okay, over here, this is n over 2, n plus 1 over 2, minus 2n. Plus, if we were to simplify this, right, this will actually just give us 3 over 8 or minus 1 over 9 to the power of n. Right? Now, why are we doing it? Because remember, we have an end point to look forward to. We have an end point. We want to get to something like this form. Right? So we are always working towards that. And from here, simplifying this. Okay? Simplifying this portion, we will get n bracket n squared plus 2n minus 1. Okay, I need you to work this out for yourself. This portion, if I were to simplify it, this is what I'll get. Okay, I'm not going to show you how it's done. You can try working it by yourself. And on the right hand side, 3 over 8, 1 minus 1 over 9 power n. Okay, and very quickly, comparing the original equation, comparing this equation, you can see that a basically here, a is just equals to 1. B equals to 3 over 8. Okay, so going back to the question, A equals to 1 and B is just equals to 3 over 8. Alright, and we are done with this question.